Hello friends, in this tutorial, you will learn how to animate photos using Smart Warp Layer and Mesh, so that you can create a more lively and attractive scene. For example, in this tutorial I animate some trees to make it look like the wind is blowing in the scene. First, I insert a photo of a tree into the scene from the Layers section. This picture is without background and in PNG format. You can download or buy these pictures from different sites. I will make the photo smaller. I create a new vector layer and rename it to Mesh. Using the Add Point tool, I draw the approximate shape of the tree. The Auto Weld option must be active. In this way, this shape is made. I disable the stroke and change the color of the shape. I can modify the location of the points with the transform tool. Drag the mesh layer below the photo layer. I click on the mesh layer and select Triangulate 2D Mesh from the Draw section. This is how mesh is made. Now I double click on the image layer and select the image section. In the Smart Warp Layer section, I select the mesh option. I select the mesh layer and the transform tool. Because the slider is in zero frame, there is no change by moving the points. So I put the slider in frame 1 and click on the tree with the transform tool to create keyframes in the timeline. I put the slider in frame 24 and select a number of points. With the transform tool, I change the location of the points and rotate them a little. This is how movement is created. I will correct the location of the points in frame 24. I put the slider in frame 48 and select the points again. I copy the points of frame 1 to frame 48. I copy with Ctrl and C and paste with Ctrl and V. So that the points return to their original place. Now I change the location of the points again with the transform tool. I select and copy keyframes 24, now I place the slider in frame 72 and paste. In this way, he sees that movement is created for the tree. I select all the keyframes and right-click and select the smooth option. I select keyframes number 72 and right-click and select cycle option. I write the number 24 in the above box. In this way, the movement is repeated until the end of the animation. I increase the length of the animation to 500 frames and press the play button to see the animation. Because I want the speed of the tree's movement to be slower and more natural, I select these keyframes and drag by holding the Alt button and left clicking. Now you can see that the movement of the tree has become more natural and it seems that the wind is blowing in the scene. I select the image layer and mesh and right-click and put them in a group. I will name the group G. I take a duplicate from this group to create another tree. I will change its location and make it smaller. In group G2, I select the mesh layer and move the keyframes a little closer together so that the movement of both trees is not the same. I make another duplicate of group G2 to create a third tree. The slider must be in 0 frame. I repeat the same thing for the group G3. In the G3 group, I select the mesh layer and move the keyframes further apart. Hold down the Alt key. In this empty layer, I make a land. I change its color. Now I will take a rendering so you can see the final animation. Thank you for being with me until the end of this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye until the next video.